Hi guys, this is Ashwini Rudrakshi. Welcome to my channel. And today we are going to see how to paint a seagull. Light wash mixing Naples yellow and gently blending towards the beak and slowly working to the areas where I want to give a wash. Working towards the eyes. Today I'm using Chinese brushes. These brushes are really good and it has a lovely point to it. I am trying to give a wash wherever I want to have the bright yellow, but of course with a very watery consistency. Now I'm mixing some cool grays and warm grays, trying to give a wash on top of the yellow which I created. So this is not my actual working speed. I have increased the frame rate just to save your time and get the things faster. I'm blending cool grays and warm grays, and also at the same time I'm blending the colors which I had given earlier. And you see that water is seeping into the area where I don't want to have any color. So I'm putting the tissue paper and taking all the paint. I'm using a little cool gray by mixing Persian blue and a little bit of orange. I'm working wet and wet here and leaving some of the white spaces for the feather. I'm using various tonal values from light to dark, working at the same time. Saving some of the white and blending the edges. I am using the tip of the brush to create the thin fine lines, and the tail which I'm working right now, I'm using the gray color. It's a cool gray and I want to blend it and also at the same time giving the darker color in it. So I want to balance it out with the colors what I have, and also working on the beak now, mixing vermilion, red and orange. Of course this is the first wash, so it is going to be lighter, and I'm saving some of the areas where I don't want to have color. So I want to have the paper white, so I'm saving those paper white. And look at the brush, it has a very fine point. And these brushes are really good to work with. These are the natural hair brushes. And now I'm mixing a little burnt umber just to blend a little bit dark tones. Working detail of the beak. and also trying to see the edge of the feather and the beak, and gently mixing it, blending to the paper white. And now I'm working on the legs using the same colors, vermilion red, orange, and a little bit of yellow ochre. I'm not using masking fluid and I'm saving paper white because I'm not a big fan of using masking fluid, and I feel this technique is much better, or maybe I'm used to that kind of technique. So now I'm giving a little bit of darker tones, blending again in wet and wet. Most of my paintings are blended in wet and wet and work towards the detailing part. Trying to get the shape of the feet. The other leg, working with the merging of the feather, the line of the feather and the leg. So I'm trying to re-emphasize the colors here as I go. Trying to gently merge the colors. Here I'm using more of orange and red. Dropping a little dark accents on the areas where I want to emphasize a little bit of shadow. And mixing a little bit of gray in the palette, and now coming and giving the shadow base for the feather, giving a rough edge of the feather and blending it. I've used a different brush here for the blending. Trying to emphasize the roundity of the belly, so I'm using a little gray in here and merging the edges. I'm coming up with the different brushes in here just to see how they give a different texture to it. And now I'm working towards the detailing of the face. Gently merging the edges and blending the colors which I'm putting. Mostly I'm using two types of grays, that is a cool gray and warm gray. I'm dabbing the brush on the rag and getting the proper consistency of water in the brush. It looks good to me, almost near to the completion. I don't want to overwork here, just to, you know, give a emphasize. I am going to blend a little bit more on the beak with the details, with the darker colors, adding in burnt umber and giving a shadow below the beak and clearing the shape. The eye has to be carefully worked because it's very small. I'm using some yellow for the pupil, burnt umber, Prussian blue, little grays here. I'm using a little warm gray just to emphasize again on the areas where I had worked earlier. It's about to dry, so I just want to come and drop few of the accent colors on the leg before it dries. I will be working on the beak in just a while. I want to work on the detail part, so I want to let it dry for some time. And now I'm just redefining very very small feathers around the bird, the body of the bird. So it's a cool gray again, it's the penis gray, very very light. And I don't want to give a dark outline or something. So also I'm leaving some of the gaps in between, not to really redefine the outline, to make it feel the feathery look. I'm not going to paint the background, so I'm creating this outline. Otherwise I would have just, you know, merged this into the background color. Just dabbing the brush and merging the paint. Now I'm coming with little darker colors just to emphasize some of the areas on the wing, blending nicely. So I'm almost done here. Again giving some of the depth under the wing just to make it a little more dimensional look. I'm giving a little warmer gray here mixed with a little umber, raw umber. Giving some depth again under the wings to show the variation of tonal values. Your picture will look more beautiful. Some more details on the beak. And now I'm working on the eyes. I'm leaving one small highlight in the eye. Mixing some of the color for the face. Giving some more texture on the body and blending the edges. Splashing some blue color in the background. I want to blend it up with blue and a little warm color, and I also want to give some tinge of blue in the body, so I'm just dabbing some cobalt blue. The same cobalt blue I'm using for the background, just to merge out the outlines which I created. Blending a little bit of red with cobalt blue, so I get a little balance of warm and cool colors. And I want to have some neutral colors also, so I'm blending those two colors to get some neutral grays. At the same time, I want to keep it cool and warm grays. A little darker color in the background. I'm using a small brush here just to control the water. I don't want to have more of a water in the background. So now I want to have a little bit of loose outlines on the legs. So I'm just blending a little bit so that just the color bleeds a little bit outside, and giving a final touch in the eye. A little shadow near the feet. I'm using yellow ochre and a little bit of blue, Persian blue. It's almost done now. Just blending some of the areas wherever I feel that there are some hard edges. And also checking in the balance of the color. So mixing some red and blue for the background. Yes, I think it's coming out nice. I really liked the way how the colors have blended, and I like the neutral grays here and the blending. Hope you guys like it. Do comment what you think about this painting. If you like my video, consider it subscribing and sharing with your friends. I will see you in the next video. See you. Bye-bye.